Hi, I'm Julieta from the Ensembl Outreach team. How can you view your own data in Ensembl? There are multiple ways to do this. I'm going to start with a BAM file and show it along the genome in the region in detail view as an example. This BAM file contains alignments to the GRCH37 assembly of low coverage Illumina sequencing reads of chromosome 20. I'll need both the BAM file and the index file. They are at these URLs. First, I'm going to navigate to chromosome 20. I'm especially interested in the CDH22 gene, so I'll navigate to the location tab for that gene in human. You don't have to log in, but I'm going to because that way I can save my data to my accounts. Whatever computer I log in from, I can access my data. Plus, registration is free. I'm going to log in here. From the home page, I'm going to change the species to human, type CDH22, and click Go. Expand gene, and click on human. I'll click directly on the location on chromosome 20 to go to region in detail. Now I'll click on Add Your Data. I'll fill out this short form. I'm going to name the track Illumina Reads. My data is for human, so I will leave that as is. It's a BAM file, so I'll select that. You can see lots of other supported file types below. To read more about them, check out our documentation. I can now put in the URL of the BAM file. Now I'll click Attach. And that's it. Note, I didn't see an upload option, only a URL attachment option. That's because BAM files are too big to upload to the Ensembl database, so only URL attachment is possible for that type of file. We'll do another example in a minute where we upload a file directly. I actually don't need to attach the index file. As long as it's in the same directory as my BAM file, Ensembl will find it. So I can close the menu now to see my Illumina reads. The track name is Illumina reads, as I specified during the attachment process. If I zoom in by clicking and dragging with my mouse, I can see the sequence of the reads themselves. You have to zoom in pretty far to see the actual sequence. Okay, I'm just going to zoom out again using the zoom slide. If I hover over the track name and then the eye icon, I can see information, for example, that the green blocks at the ends mean both mates are part of a proper pair. Did you know you can customize this view easily by turning off tracks like this constrained elements track? Just hover over the track name and click the X. I can also move the tracks around. For example, if I want to compare the Illumina reads directly to the gene, I can move it down next to CDH22. Once I finish my customization, I can either save this panel as an image or share it with a collaborator. If you use the share icon, It will ask you whether or not you want to share your data track or if you'd rather not. It'll give you a URL that you can send around. I'll select Illumina Reads to share my data with a collaborator and click Accept. It gave me a URL that I can now send around, and others can see my same view. So can I use a smaller file and upload to Ensembl? I'll do this with a GFF file of splice variants. Add your data has become manage your data, since I already have data in Ensembl. Now I click manage your data in the left-hand menu. It will actually bring me directly to the Illumina Reads. So I'm going to navigate to add your data to add something else. Let's name this one INSR, for the INSR gene, GFF. Again, I'm in human, so I will leave that as it is. And I will choose the file type as GFF. Now I get the choice to either upload to Ensembl or attach with a URL, as I did before. I'll leave it on upload. I'm going to upload my file by choosing a file, but you could also paste the data directly in the box. Click Upload. It worked. I'll follow the link to the nearest region with data, which is on chromosome 19. I can see my data as these green blocks. Maybe I want to add some labels. To do this, hover over the track name and change the track style. I'll change it to labels. There are other views I can see my data in, for example, the karyotype. If I click on Whole Genome and then Manage Your Data and then Features on Karyotype, it gives me options to paste in some IDs or gene names. I'll paste in 4 gene names. Note there are other types of IDs it will accept. I can go with the default or choose a different color or styling. You may want to choose red one time and then blue for a second data set to compare them, for example. Now I will click Show Features. My 4 genes are shown along the karyotype as red arrows. And then if I scroll down, I can see a list of where they map to. You may have noticed that we're collecting all our data tracks and can see them in Manage Your Data. Now I can see 3 sets of data. However, they are not saved to my account. If I want to save them to my account, I have to click on this little floppy disk icon. Now it's saved, and you can see the icon is grayed out. Once you save a set to your account, you can actually see it any time you log in from any computer. Note there are some other actions you can take, like deleting a data set completely, or sharing it with collaborator with a URL as we did before. By the way, you can see the same Manage Your Data window if you go to Configure this page and then click on Personal Data. That will take you to the same place. Okay, finally, what if you have a list of alleles and genomic positions? You can use our most popular tool called the VEP to load them in and to determine the effect on genes and transcripts. Go to the Tools menu and click on VEP, Variant Effect Predictor. In the example here, we see one insertion and one SNP, or single nucleotide polymorphism. Let's name this just quickly. You can click Next, then HTML. Here are the results of that example. We see any genes and transcripts in the region of these variants, and we also see exactly where those variants fall, either downstream or within the coding sequence, for example. If I follow the link to a location, I go to the Region in Detail page, and a test VEP track will be turned on. Now if I click the cogwheel icon here, you may see there is a Your Data menu. This allows me to display my data tracks within the view that I'm in, so within the region in detail view in this case. So for example, all three of the data tracks are turned on here. I can also turn on those selected genes from features in a karyotype. And I can select normal or labels. These will only be displayed if I'm in the correct region. So for example, I'm in chromosome 1. I would have to navigate back to maybe chromosome 20 in order to see other tracks. You can also share data by creating a group if you have logged in to your account. Edit settings. Create a new group. But that's in another video. If you have any questions or comments about this video, contact our help desk.